gotta do.
There's a level C that's on. Yeah, if it's Royce the Wardrobe, then press it. Alright.
Thank you.
explosives, we need to kill you.
Need you guys to secure the smuggling operation at the warehouse.
I'll send them over. And Lincoln, just cause Greco's a dipshit doesn't mean he's a pushover. They'll probably send out some of his men, have them try and take you out. So watch your ass. Get your hands on Greco and rough him up all you want, but don't kill him. That's for me.
Vito agreed to work with Lincoln on one condition. that he bring him Michael Greco. When Greco escaped, Vito backed out.
Oh, restarting the checkpoint, yeah. Why can't I stop with the name of shitty Vito? She better. Shoot the driver so he can't ride. I don't know why Vito doesn't talk to the driver. More loading. It's not here,
How the fuck did Greco end up with my car?
He's a little fuck, that's how.
God damn it, why don't you just let Marcano handle this jackass?
Marcano would just kill the little shit stain. I want to take my time. Besides, until I can get at Marcano directly, this is the next best goddamn thing.
Point taken.
Lincoln had of bringing down Sal Marcano ended with the death of Vito Scaletta.
Cops, go away, cops. Cops, go away. Go away, cops. Cops, why are you going to do that? I'm just come home and survive another day. Like, he's dying. Vito died because he's weak. Vito used to be badass from the team. Now he's just dying in these shots.
Jack in the back. And as for you, have a little dignity, Christ.
Help! Somebody fucking help! Help!
Watch out for cops. Don't want to get pulled over with this asshole in the back seat. Whew, shit. For a couple of years there, I really thought I might be done with all the Jimmy Cagney bullshit. But here I am.
Funny, I kind of figured you for more the Edward G. Robinson type.
Look at you, kid. You know, God's got a sense of humor, too. It's sick as shit, but that motherfucker...
Please! I didn't do nothing!
You didn't do nothing? You were getting ready to fucking kill me!
I was just doing what Uncle Sal told me to do!
Ah, that fuck never liked me, I get it. But this? You never tried anything like this before.
I don't...
Come on, Mikey, why do you want me gone all of a sudden?
Said you were a carpetbagger. Never should have been down here in the first place.
You want me to keep going? You got 9 more!
Fuck! Listen, Jesus! He was worried you knew about the casino! And you were gonna play up to Leo and the commission!
What casino?
Answer the question.
Uncle Sally's... You see that construction across the lake? He's building a casino over there. He wants to go legit. Turn this city into Las Vegas.
Gambling's illegal.
Yeah, no shit, it's illegal. Which is why he's paid a bunch of money to get the laws changed.
Who else is involved in this?
I don't know. I don't know, I swear it. Look, I told you what you wanted to know. You're gonna let me go now, right?
Yeah, sure. Stupid fucking prick. I'll clean this mess up. No reason for you to stick around.
Remember our deal. I'm expecting a cut of everything you bring in.
Yeah, I know how this shit works. You'll get your money. There's a woman named Alma. Helps me outside the house. Cuban. Mean as fuck. Should talk to her, see if she needs anything. Might be an easy way to bring in some extra money.
Where's she at?
At the warehouse.
All right. What are you gonna do with him?
Fish gotta eat like everyone else.
At what point did you become aware that Sal Marcano wanted to build a casino north of the city?
Pretty early on. Michael Greco told Lincoln about it.
And Lincoln Clay's plan was to specifically target various entities related to Marcano's casino plan?
Between the bribes he was paying out to get gambling legalized and the money needed to pay off the commission, Sal was stretched pretty thin. So Lincoln used that to his advantage. Forced Sal into making some extremely hard decisions. Decisions that would limit his options.
I'm telling you, we make twice as much bread moving heroin as we would from a stupid fucking casino. Maybe 3 times.
This ain't about the money.
You're joking, right? All I ever heard from you is, don't give me that goddamn excuses, you understand? You pay me what's fucking owed!
You think this is a game, son? And it's my fault for playing along with you. We're not setting you straight. But it's not a game. This shit wears on you, grinds you down. I ain't had a decent night's sleep in 43 years. And then after Lucho,
hey, we got the cocksuckers who did that. Every last one of them.
Yeah, and your uncle's still dead, ain't he? Yeah. You think sitting in that chair makes you special, huh? Somehow puts you above all the bullshit. But it's the opposite. All it does is paint a giant goddamn bullseye on your forehead. There's a price to be paid for all this, you understand? And I'm tired of paying it. Mainly, I'm worried I'm gonna get a phone call telling me you're dead in a gutter somewhere.
What do you expect me to do, huh? Work the front door? Glad hand folks as they come on in, maybe give them a quick slap on the ass?
You run it with me. And here, after a few years, after I know everything's settled down, you'll take over. Find yourself a nice woman. give me some fucking grandkids.
Sounds boring as fuck.
It's the only way, son. The world is changing. Used to be people knew their place. Now everybody's screaming about equality. Now they all deserve a slice of the pie. Niggas, Knicks, gooks, you name it. Our way of doing things won't work in a world like that. Yeah. You come to me with something like this, Lou, you better be goddamn sure. Yeah.
Lincoln Clay is still alive.
Fuck me.
No, okay.
Believe that? And if you see me out and about, just say hello. I might just...
水。已经重金子了，也是少人军吧，现在。
Something? Need to talk to Cassandra.
She said you could use some help. Assuming you're a man.
Assume at your own risk, Lincoln Clay.
So running the weed, y'all got a routine laid out?
We take a boat to the bayou, grab the bears, bring them back.
Bayou can be a rough territory. Dixie Mafia knows every inch.
Did those white boys scare you, friend? Did they touch your zozo when you were shy?
Cassandra failed to mention your charming personality.
I highly doubt she forgot.
You do this kind of thing back in Haiti?
Back in my country, I was a hoogan, a priest.
What does a priest know about trafficking weed?
I did not run marijuana, friend. My cargo was refugees, people. I saved their lives, got them away from Duvalier. But you probably don't know much about that.
We gonna have a problem, you and me?
Cassandra says we are partners, that everything is cool between us. Are we cool?
Don't think I call it that.
Neither would I. Cassandra might be able to let go of what you did to our people. But I cannot.
Maybe you'd be happier back in Haiti.
It was not my choice to come here. Leave my home. But I'm trying to make the best of it.
Aren't we all?
There are still Dixie Mafia scattered around the hollow. If you have the time, you should see to them. Convince them to leave.
Shipments of weed is being delivered down in the bayou. Get a boat, use it to bring him. trust you had to have to put the holler in my hands. You won't regret it.
something here. Yeah, I don't say if I was just lying as well. I was just there. I said, please listen.